Let's get rid of the fake tan.
All of this.
Currently working on the new sunny side designs. Pretty good idea of what it's gonna look like.
Just me working hard today then.
JK Barry. Hot cross bun testing is back. Happy Easter. Hello everyone. Welcome back to the weekly vloggity. I hope you're all good. Hope you're having a lovely Sunday so far, or whatever day it is when you're watching this. Feels like a little while since I've done a weekly vlog, actually, because there is reason for it. We've had all our doors changed in our house, and naive little me, I thought it was like a one day job. I thought someone would come in, take the old door off, put the old door on. No, it took, I think, 5 days of having him in the house, and it was like loud work as well, because obviously like every door is a slightly different shape in our house, so we haven't got a new build, so I had to file the doors down, etc, etc. But they're all done now, so I can vlog again. I feel really awkward vlogging when there's someone else in the house, but I am back showing you what I get up to this week. Haven't got much planned for today, but we'll see what happened. I just filmed a little TikTok, and I used this. I've used this a few times now from Batiste. It's their new leave-in dry conditioner. It is so good, honestly. I will be repurchasing this again and again, especially in the tropical scent. It's a foam, so I'll put a video on screen. Foam slash mousse kind of thing. You put it through your hair, and it makes my hair feel like, the only way I can describe it is, you know when you've just been to the hairdresser and your hair feels really lovely, it feels different to normal. That's how it makes it feel. Feels so smooth and just really well conditioned. So yeah, I'm a big fan of this, would recommend it. I don't know where you can get it, probably Boots, Superdrug, maybe even like supermarkets.
Who's that barking? Oh, it's you. You want to play?
Sunny went for a groom yesterday. Don't you look so smart? She always looks so grown up after a groom.
What's this? Oh, that's a big yawn. Hello. Say hello, everyone. Oh, she give you a kiss.
Let's show everyone your haircut. Come here, Sunny. Look, sit down.
Good girl. So you like my new hair, everyone? My head is so fluffy and soft. Everyone can feel my little tiny skull now.
We ask her groomer, Cindy, she's lovely, to keep her face long and her ears long, and then the rest of her body just goes shorter. She was a bit matted this time. But as long as her face is long, she still looks like a little girly girl. Don't look at her bum hole. Oh, you definitely looked at her bum hole.
I've come up to the office to pack some orders, but I've got stuck in playtime. Haven't I?
Go!
So that's what we're doing. Sorry if you've got a dog and they're going mad at the squeaks.
Go!
Go on then, you can get it. Are you scared of the camera?
This, by the way, guys, is Sunny's favourite office toy. I introduce you to Tommy Arto. That's his name, isn't it? First name Tommy, second name Arto. He can sit next to you while you have a nap, please.
Until this point, it was unknown if the killer was posting take items from the family's trash. Came back the following day. On the knife sheet was a match report. Like, ugly, his father's DNA on trash.
Good morning, my fine fellows. Oh. I remember being a 12-year-old boy. Voice broke. If you watched my previous video, you may have seen that I have pink eyebrows. Happy to announce that I got a new brow product. Same one. The NYX Lift and... what is it? Lift and Shape? Lift and something. I got a new shade, so now my eyebrows aren't pink anymore. So, happy Thursday. I'm wearing my Saving Grace hoodie today. This is one of those hoodies that hoodies like no other hoodies. Do you know what I mean? Like, you know, you have the best ones in your wardrobe. You've got the hoodies that like, you like how they look, but you don't love how they feel. This one feels so nice. It's almost like a bit spongy. Is that weird? Got me SG on. Back of it looks like this. Oh my God, those boys that do like working out in the gym and they're like this. Me and my Saving Grace. Anyway, I'm about to have breakfast. I'm gonna have a hot cross bunny this morning. I wanna go to Tesco and get some different flavours of hot cross buns. Was anyone subscribed to my channel when I did the hot cross bun tasting video? Why did I think that was a good idea? To be fair, I still get messages about that, being like, lol, remember when you did this? Yeah, I do remember. But some of those hot cross buns were delicious. I had like blueberry ones. So I wanna go to Tesco at some point and see if they've got the new range in, limited editions. But for this morning, it's a standard hot cross bun. And I don't know why I've been filming for 1 minute and 58 seconds about nothing, about guys in the gym and hot cross buns. Why do you watch these vlogs? Two fun facts about me on this Thursday morning is I love hot cross buns, but I don't like raisins, even though they're in them. And another thing is I use a bread knife for everything. And I've had comments on it in my video because, I don't know, my mum's always been the same. Like, this knife just does everything. It cuts the bread. I can do the butter with this side. Why do I need a butter knife? And I get comments about that all the time. Like, I will cut ham with this, cheese with this. Don't know why it's called a bread knife. It should be called a everything knife, in my opinion. Anyway, glad we cleared that up.
What the hell? I'm so upset. This happens nearly every day. I swear every hot cross bun in this packet takes a different amount of time to toast. Today's clearly didn't take long at all. It doesn't even look it on camera, but it's so burnt. Oh, thanks a lot, Rachel.
Did another one, didn't I? I look like a GK Barry fangirl this morning. I've got my hoodie on.
And I'm watching the new podcast of Rob Beckett. Look at Sunny down there in the sun. Oh my goodness. She is just so adorable. Really living up to her name right now. Imagine if I called her Rain. She hates the rain.
So I didn't vlog anything yesterday because I'm currently working on the new Sunnyside designs. I have three in production right now and then another six that I'm currently in the stages of planning and like almost sending to Alice to actually design. So I've been putting together the documents for Alice to like show her my ideas, what graphics I want to use, the colour schemes, things like that. The thing that I'm stuck on at the moment, right, this might be really boring to some of you, but if anyone's hooked textiles or anything like that, if you're a bit creative, you might find this interesting. So for one of the seamless patterns, it's like a sea theme. That's all I'm going to say for now. But I can't decide whether to put water in the background so it looks like it's kind of in the sea, which is what I'm looking at right now. Or,
because the harnesses are obviously fabric, there's like a little bit of texture to it anyway.
Because obviously the design that I've made on my laptop, if it's just a plain background, it looks really flat, but obviously when it's printed on fabric, there is a bit of texture to it. So do I let the texture be the sea, or do I add the sea to the texture? You see what I mean? Like, it's kind of similar to this one.
You can see there's like a watercolor sky in the background. Do you know what I mean? You can see it well down there. So it's not like completely flat. It's not just a navy background. It's like textured.
But that's the decision I'm currently making, but I'm so happy with, I think I've finalized, I want to say 5 out of 6 designs now. The 6th design, I'm just trying to find some graphics to show Alice that I really love so she knows the kind of vibe I'm going for, but I haven't found those exact graphics yet. But I love this part of the planning process. I find it so fun. And I always mock up the harnesses in Photoshop to see what the final product's going to look like as well.
So for example, this was my very first mock-up of the Berry Lovely harness. And here it is in comparison. So I can get a pretty good idea of what it's going to look like by making it on Photoshop.
Hello again, me from the car. Change of setting. Oh, I forgot I got this.
Ooh.
Mum and I have just come to KFC for our lunch today. Just woke up and really fancied KFC today. Where's your...
You want the cocktail?
No, I wanted rice instead. Mm-hmm. There's your chips. Boneless mini fillets for you. Boneless mini fillets for me. I've never got a side of the rice from KFC, but I like the
it's
rice
hot.
Boxes.
Careful.
Mm, barbecue sauce as well, but we didn't get the KFC barbecue sauce. We got the Heinz barbecue sauce. Anyway, I'm going to enjoy our KFC now. Let me know in the comments down below, what do you get from KFC? Don't know why, but I always feel like the KFC menu is a lot more intimidating than the McDonald's one. McDonald's, I understand. KFC confuses me a little bit. All the zingers and the fillets and the this meal and that meal.
Hello, sweet girl. I missed you. Come and see me.
Oh, I missed you, little girl.
Hello.
Go on, then.
Hello.
Look what we brought home for you from KFC. Bit of chicken.
Sit down.
Oh, is that so yummy? Good morning, everyone. Today I'm feeling very green, green grass. I've got this green tracksuit on today. I got this from Boohoo right this week. I really like it. If you watch my vlogs regularly, you know that I do not wear colour, like ever, pretty much. I'm such a neutrals kind of gal. But I saw this colour on Boohoo and I was like, you know what? I really like that. Very out of my, not out of my comfort zone, but very out of my usual style. So I grabbed it. It was only £35 for the hoodie and the tracksuit. I really like it, it's really nice quality. It's got this on the back. I can't actually remember what it says, but it's embroidered, so very nice quality. And the joggers, let me show you them. They've got everything I like in a jogger. They're baggy, they've got a drawstring waist, they're cuffed at the bottom, they're fleecy inside, and they've got pockets. I don't think I'm yet brave enough to wear the hoodie and the joggers out together.
I just don't know if I can pull that off. But I definitely will wear them separately, like the green hoodie with black leggings, and then in the summer, the joggers with a little white t-shirt. I just thought very mix and match. But when I'm at home, lovely. I feel a bit like, I swear, in some kind of film, there's a Santa Claus in a green tracksuit running, but I can't think what that's from. I do feel a bit like that. I look in the mirror and I'm like, I look like Santa from that movie. Long story short, even though that was long. Yesterday, I went to Tesco. After our little hot cross bun chat, I inspired myself. Now, I'm not gonna lie, they didn't have the selection of hot cross buns that they had many years ago. I'm gonna try one of each this morning. Apple and cinnamon hot cross buns. And, not sure how I feel about these, but I wanna try them. Red velvet hot cross buns with white chocolate chunks, dark chocolate chips, and soft cream cheese. And let's try not to burn them today. Hot cross bun testing is back. I would never choose red velvet cake out and about. Does that make me weird? Probably. Happy Easter. No, stop. It's actually really nice. Oh my goodness. It's like a cake. Look at the texture of it. It's actually really nice, guys. I wasn't expecting to like that. I can't remember if I tried it years ago. Right. Apple and cinnamon. I know I'm going to like this one. Mmm. Delish. It tastes like the kind of hot cross bun that a rich middle-aged woman would love, or a 24-year-old from Essex. She's an all-rounder for everyone. Get yourself to Tesco and try both of these. I can't remember how much they were, but they're not gonna cost the earth, are they? They're only hot cross buns. I've put you guys on a tripod. P.S. Look at our new doors. Aren't they nice? I mean, like, pretty much every house in England has these doors, but we like them. Anyway, you're on a tripod because I've decided that I'm going to declutter my fake tan shelf today. If you're new around here, I quit fake tanning, I want to say, like, 6 months ago. And before that, it was a full-blown addiction. Like, once a week, every single week, I would fake tan. Wouldn't see me dead without fake tan. And then I saw a TikTok from another girl that had gone cold turkey and quit the fake tan altogether. And she was saying how she feels so much more confident in her own skin. And I was like, you know what? I'm going to do that. So it was literally like an overnight change for me. Well, it wasn't. It took me about 3 weeks to scrub off every inch of tan. Honestly, I couldn't believe how long it took. And I honestly thought that I would look in the mirror and be like, I look disgusting. I feel so pale and gross. But then I realised, like, why is that my mindset? Pale and gross do not equate. That doesn't make sense. And once I literally flipped my mindset and was like, that's not gross, it's just pale. I have never once looked in the mirror and thought, I look gross because I'm pale. Don't get me wrong, I've looked in the mirror and thought, Han, you look rough. But not because I'm pale, just because I look rough. But all in all, I do feel a lot more confident for not fake tanning. I don't know how I'm gonna feel in the summer, I will say that, because I haven't got to the sunny weather yet, and my legs are probably my biggest insecurity when it comes to pale skin. Let's get rid of the fake tan. This is what the shelf looks like currently. I've got a few little bits and bobs at the front here. This is my makeup brush cleaner, which I really need to do actually. And then all of this is my fake tan section. There's scrubs, exfoliators, most of it is mousse tans, face mist. These are all my mitts and my brushes. I want to pretty much clear this shelf today. If you'd have told me 8 months ago you're gonna throw all of this away one day, I'd have been like, you are mad. I'm gonna keep these two scrubs because obviously it's good to exfoliate your body whether you fake tan or not. That's not the issue. And I'm gonna keep this exfoliating mitt as well. This scrub though, I'm gonna get rid of that just because it's been open for ages. Moisturizers. This stuff is probably what I will use in the summer if I'm having a bit of a self-conscious day. It's just like a tinted moisturizer kind of, but it's a really good one and I love the smell of it. But this one, tan enhancing moisturizer, gonna get rid of. Filter by Molly May. One of my most viewed videos was testing this. I did really like it, to be fair. Extra dark though. You would not catch me buying extra dark tan ever these days. And the dark tanny mousse, to be fair, I wouldn't even buy a dark now. If I was gonna fake tan, it would be medium at best. Skinny tan, instant tan, she's going. The one that I think I'm gonna keep is this one from St. Moritz. It is quite old, so I don't know if I would actually use it, but it's the instant and gradual, and you kind of like leave it on for however long you want. So you don't have to leave it on all night if you don't want to be super dark. You can leave it on for like 3 hours and then wash it off. So I think this will be a good option for me. I'm not against a face tan, sorry. This is a really difficult angle to film. I don't just want to talk with my hands, but also this kind of hurts my neck. Especially this face mist, it's not too strong. I
I feel like in the summer it might be a little bit nice just to have a little bit of a glow more than a tan. And these self-tanning drops from Isle of Paradise, these are so good to drop into a face moisturiser. You could just drop like a couple in, just for, again, a little bit of a healthy summer glow rather than a fake tan. Medium dark, she's going. This is another one from Tanologist that's like, leave it on for as long as you want, but you can wash it off sooner if you don't want to be that tan. So I'm going to keep her, and it's only in shade medium. I'm literally keeping these for emergencies, because if I'm going to a wedding or something, then I will still fake tan. Dark Coco and Eve. Goodbye. Skinny tans. I loved skinny tan. I feel a bit sad to get rid of these, but you've got to go. Saint Tropez. This one hasn't even been opened, so I'm actually going to keep this one. Throw this one because that's been open for ages. Again, 1 hour light, 2 hours medium, 3 hours dark. Healthier for my mindset than just going full force, 8 hours dark tan, I think. Dark St. Moritz. This was my go-to. We had good times, but you also made me feel insecure without you. As for the mitts, I mean, I've got some that haven't even been taken out of the packet, so they're the ones that are going to stay, because by the time I come to fake tanning, potentially, around in the summer, I'm not going to want to use a mitt that I've used a year ago. So literally all of these that have been used, I'm going to throw away. I want to try and fit all my tan stuff in here. For reference, these are the three proper tans that I'm keeping for weddings, occasions, etc. Then we've got the little face section, the moisturiser, the mitts, the exfoliating glove, and the body scrubs are the only thing that don't fit in. But I would argue these are just general skincare as well as a fake tan section. So now, all my fake tan stuff fits in here. I'm so happy with that. So much better. Guys, I just realised this is also a gradual tan, so I'm going to swap this one for this one. One of my skinny tans is staying. And now we say goodbye to my old life. And this is what the shelf looks like now. So much better. I'll probably move these around, maybe put some like body moisturizers in here or something, just because I've got so much extra space now. But I've got my little wax machine at the back there, my Estrid razors, this is a hair curler, and then I've got my fake tan basket, so chuffed with that. Exfoliators, makeup brush cleaner, and a few little moisturizers and this spray. Good job done. So this is the green tracksuit that I showed you this morning. I love this one. It's from Boohoo. Did I say that? Not sure. But I also ordered two other green tracksuits to try, which I haven't tried on yet. I don't know why I've done that, because I only wanted to keep one, and I've already taken the labels off for this one because I put this one on first and loved it. So let's hope I don't love the other two, because I'm planning to return them. So I got this one in sage green, which is a really lovely colour, but it doesn't have a pocket on the front, and that's like, I feel like I want to put my hand in the pocket all the time. But on the back of this, it has like this printed bubble writing, and it's also on the joggers as well. They do have pockets. They are nice quality. I just don't like that it doesn't have the little pouch at the front. And this is the third one. I'm not gonna lie, this one feels the least quality out of the three. It feels a lot thinner. It's not elasticated around the cuffs. But again, I love the colour of this. And the thing I love, right, the joggers, they are a bit short. I knew they would be. As soon as I got out of the packet, I was like, they're not going to fit me. The colour's a little bit more toned down than the one I'm decided to keep. I'm not going to keep this one, but I do love the fit of these joggers around the waist. They've got a drawstring inside, but I love how they look. I got them in a size large. I got all of these in a large, by the way. But these ones definitely had the baggiest waist, but when you pulled it in, I really like this like cinched look. I think with a little white top they would look really cute, but they are too short. Little bit ankle grazers. So the bright green stays. We're at the office, office, office. That exciting? Office, office, office. I've just come up this afternoon to get some orders out. I don't like, sorry, the printer's really loud. I don't like to let it get to the weekend and have like Friday orders outstanding, just because otherwise I think people are waiting too long for their orders. We're like Amazon Prime, aren't we, Sunny? We get them out on the day or the day after. Sent first class, straight to your door. Oh, just me working hard today then. That's all right, she's having a day off. Have a break, have a Kit Kat. Oh, look how pretty the sky looks tonight. Pink sky at night, shepherd's delight. My room isn't on fire, by the way. I've got a candle on. But welcome back to another segment of things I didn't need, but I've bought. My Adenola order just arrived, guys. And when I tell you I've been waiting for this hoodie for months, is it months? At least a month. I'm pretty sure it's since before Christmas. I've been signed up to the email notifications of when they would restock it. I'll show you the hoodie in a sec, but I also bought
the t-shirt and the joggers and the socks. Not gonna lie, I think that expensive socks, like, you know, the Nike version of these, I think they're such a waste of money. They're so expensive. But I thought I'm gonna get these for myself as a little treat because I wear a lot of black leggings with little white socks. So I was like, I'll get myself them once. I will not be repurchasing. £9 for one pair of socks is ridiculous in my opinion. So yeah, I got the socks, the t-shirts. I thought in summer this would be nice with my black leggings and my socks. And then I'm gonna try this on for the first time, the hoodie, but it feels such nice quality. Oh my goodness, I'm obsessed. It's quite heavy, which I really, really love. TikTok has changed me. I never ever used to jump on fashion trends, like buy things that other people would buy for the sake of it. Well, maybe I did sometimes, but not a lot. But now that TikTok is a thing, if someone mentions a product and I think that looks nice, it's too easy to hop on the website or click the link that they've added and buy it. My bank account is suffering. And I'm supposed to be saving to move out right now. But this hoodie and joggers, even though I've got practically the same ones without the words on, they were a must in someone's world. But the sky's got even prettier. Look at this. Out of my bedroom window now. Look at that. Lovely. I'm going to my friend Molly's tonight with all my best friends. We're having a pizza night. So I'm going to wear this hoodie. Don't shout at me. I normally would always wash clothes before I wear them. But it's just so comfy. I'm going to wear this with black leggings. And to make it even more basic, the Zara leather jacket. Oh my god, I literally may as well have just copied someone else's Instagram. I don't think I've ever loved a combo more. This leather jacket, honestly, it's so nice. I have had to roll the sleeves up. I've got it in a large, and it's just so long. Bought it on eBay because it's been out of stock in Zara for ages, and it came from a Spanish Zara. So she's actually Spanish leather. Spanish cow? Joking. It's not real leather. So basic, but I'm obsessed. I might even wear this to Saving Grace. I'm going to the London date and I'm very excited. GK Barry. GK Barry. Although, can I wear a tracksuit to the theatre? Whatever. Of course I can. I need to stop doing this. I started doing it as a joke and now I'm just all the time like, I'll go downstairs to my mum and be like, what do you want for lunch? Oh god. Right, you're balancing on a whole lot of cushions. You may be able to see in the mirror. If you fall over, you will hit my cup of tea, so you better stay still. It's now Saturday. It's actually Saturday evening and I've just finished editing this vlog. Since I last spoke to you, obviously went to my best mate Molly's last night with all my other friends. It was really lovely. Had a ranch barbecue Domino's pizza. Gourmet. The garlic and herb dip, honestly, from Domino's, is undefeatable. Chelsea stayed last night. We went out for lunch today and Chelsea has now gone home. My friend Chelsea lives like a couple of hours away now. She moved up to Norfolk, so every time she comes down to see the girls, she stays at my house, Hotel Han. And I slept really badly last night for some reason. It might be because I drank a Monster at like 9 o'clock. That brings us to the end of this vlog. I'm going to link everything that I've talked about in the description down below. The tracksuits, I feel like quite a lot of people are going to be asking where tracksuits are from. Links for the tracksuits. I'll also link the pink Goose and Gander sweatshirt I was wearing at the beginning because I feel like that might get some questions. The Adenola bits. It's all down in the description below for you. As always, I'm quite good at doing links in the description, if you haven't noticed. I do spend at least 15 minutes per vid doing it. You're welcome, my friends. Anyway, do subscribe to see my future videos. Let me know what video you want to see next week, actually, because currently, what have I got planned? I've got a what I eat in a day video planned for next week, but I'm not sure if I'm feeling that, so hit me with your suggestions in the comments down below. Do subscribe to see my future videos. If you enjoyed this vlog, please do give it a big thumbs up. I hope you have a lovely week next week, and I will see you again next Sunday with another little video. Bye guys. Love ya.